Hey everyone, welcome back. I'm Vivi, and today I will try the Innerworld makeup thing Isa did a few weeks ago, I think. I thought I'd just give it a shot, try to do makeup based on where I live and what my perception is of the Innerworld. I have never done makeup in this kind of form before. I usually just put on some eyeshadow and a lipstick, so it will be a challenge for me to do more than that, but I'm more than willing to try. So if you want to join me on this little journey, then grab yourself something to drink, a little snack, and let's get started. So first, I wanted to start with a foundation. I usually don't use foundation, but we have a lot of redness going on and I kind of want to start on a more even canvas. Oh no, wait. My girlfriend, or our girlfriend, got us a primer. I've never used one, but I think you just put it on your face. Why is it globally? Just like a primer, right? Primer is something you put on first. But I'm not sure. Maybe I'm doing something very wrong. And all of you will have something to laugh at, because I have no idea what I'm doing. Also, Drew wanted to do that soon as well. So would you want to see Drew struggle with a makeup look from his place in the Innerworld? Would you want to see that? Then just leave it in the comments if you are interested in this kind of stuff. I have all these globlies everywhere. I think that's not right. So I think my face is primed. So now I'm going to start with foundation. I also never used it, as I said before. So I have no idea what I am doing, but it will be okay. What's weird is I hear Jake trying to tell me how to do stuff, but I want to do this alone, so I shush him so he keeps quiet. Because I want to do this alone, I want to make my Innerworld makeup, and if it's with a bad foundation start, then it's with a bad foundation start. I am also very, very happy to say that I'm feeling a lot better right now. I think my grieving time is over. At least for the most part, I think I'm a lot better. I think I'm fine with that I've split, or that Vivi split, and part of me is now somewhere else, and that's all right. I haven't failed anyone. And I want you to remember that if you integrate or if you split, it has a reason. You are not always able to control that. Actually, a lot of the times you won't be able to control that. But it's not your fault. It's okay to split. It's okay to integrate. You're still as valid and you have not failed. Okay? What do you do next? I think you put something on foundation. It's powder. I forgot that. What else? Now I should start with my inner world stuff. Okay, I think I'm going for the half-half look as well. Just like Isa did, but in a different kind of way, I think. I kind of want to make like a scenery, because nature is a really big part of the place I am in the inner world. I'm not sure how I will get our face to be a scenery, but I guess we will find out. Now, where do I start? I think I start with doing some white overall. I'm not really sure how that works. I should also talk a bit about my inner world. I shouldn't do just makeup. So, in the inner world, I live near a forest, the dark forest, we call it. Or it's known as the dark forest. And my house itself it's a round hut. And it's made of wood, and it's all in all very cozy. It has a huge fireplace on one side. The floor is made of wood, but a big fluffy patchwork carpet is over it. I have a lot of pillows laying around. Like, I don't have a bed itself, I have a lot of pillows, and it's just very, very nice. You can sleep on the pillows and you can sleep on the floor. It's very, very comfy. So I don't need a bed in that term. That's why I don't have one. Now, recently, I also have a handle on my carpet, on one little patchwork quarter thing. And it's a little door to where Isa lives, which is very great. If you haven't seen in a recent video, Isa, who has never had any communication with our system, is now in contact with me, and we can talk to each other, and I can soothe her better, and she's just not alone anymore. So if you want more detail to that, I would recommend you check out our last upload, the one before this video. So where you can see from my and her perspective what has happened. Now, I'm glowing. It's not really white. I wanted to do the half and half one as well as Isa did, because our system and the inner world mean a lot to me. Our system and the inner world is a big part of myself. the role I have has a lot to do with the inner world. The inner world is also my safe space, and it's very important for me. I should give it a huge part. But I've never done such a huge thing of makeup, so I hope it's turning out okay later. Well, at least that's the base, I think. Now on to the more harder part. I think I'm going to do like a brownish eyeshadow. A brownish eye resembling the hut I'm living in. Then blue skyish, and here's the dark forest stuff, kind of. A piece of grass here, and I think more like sea and a little grass down here as well. So I kind of try to outline it first. This is going to be the marker of the sky. Here will be the sky. I should put the sky till here. This is where the sky will kind of be. Then here will be eyeliner, so there. And I will now firstly start doing the sky before I start doing the other parts, so it's not as confusing and I know what I'm doing. So now I'm just putting a slight lighter blue. I kind of want to make the scenery of where I live. Like when you stand in a certain angle near my house, this is kind of what you see. You see the sky with his blue tones, and you can see my little hut. It is sunken into the ground, which means that you don't see all of it. You can definitely see the roof and a bit of the space between roof and floor, like roof and grass. That's a strong blue. But also there is like the forest on the right side, and then there's a little sea, and it all has like a very light and more like colder toned color. So it's all very cold toned blues and like a cold, like a winter morning, like more like these colors, like these cold but still beautiful and wonderful colors. Like I really, really like the place I live. It has a very loving, wonderful scenery. I kind of want to give you a better view on what it looks like where I live, because we want to show you our system. We want to show what a system can be like and how different parts of the inner world can be. And I think that's easier for us to tell you about our inner world in makeup videos, where we try to represent and make how we perceive our inner world instead of just talking about it. It's just giving a different feeling, I think, and that's important for us. Because not only our inner worlds are different and places we are in are different, but our places and our inner world is probably nowhere to be found in any other system. Because everyone is different. Every brain works differently. Every human, every being is different. So keep that in mind. Just because our inner world looks like that doesn't mean that another system has an inner world that looks like that. And I also think that Isa focused a lot on how she feels in the part where she's in the inner world. Mine is probably more focused on the visual. There are a lot of blues in the sky. There are a lot of greens. A lot of reds and yellows and oranges. It really depends on where you are and what time it is, what season, if it's winter, if it's spring. So here we have a sky that could definitely be better, but it could also be definitely worse. So we will be okay with that. Are we okay with that? I hope so. I hope you are okay with that. Because I am. Give your best and don't beat yourself down. Because it's not like you wanted it to be. It's important. Not everything is going to be like you want it to be. You can work on it, but don't beat yourself down if it's not right the first time. Now I'm going to mark forest, where the dark forest part will be, and it will be in this big part. But I will do this probably later when I'm finished with the other two. What I also wanted to do is the grassy part, which will be here, all over here. It will be my little grassy place, a little grassy place. And as well, it's probably not going to look like grass or like scenery. I just want you to know I tried my best, and this is what I will end up with. Seems like like the colors you can draw with that change with what, like, you draw with in water, like watercolor. They're very soft, and I really like the gradient of the blue onto the green. So now we have the grassy part. And I thought differently. I think I'm going to make the flower field, because I really like the flower fields that are near where I live. Like, they are beautiful. Like, super beautiful. They are out of like lavender and pinky flowers, so it's a nice color combination, and I think it's something that would fit this more pastelly kind of look. Since we already have blue, I think I'm going to put the rose tones in for the flower field together with purple. Thank you. Also, I'm not sure if you're able to see what I'm doing because it really seems like not a lot because it's a lot in more pastelly light colors. But that's what I really like this more light colors, this lavendery, this light blue, and this minty, I like teal, like all these kind of things. Now, I can switch brushes from my usual brushes to the other ones for the dark forest. Because I could do more structure. Oh my god, I have to do that after the forest thing. So, if you couldn't guess, the dark forest is more in a dark tone. So the camera just cut the video. I'm sorry. I'm filming for an eternity. I apologize. And I hope it's not too long for you. Please don't go. Don't leave me like the camera just did. That is a good one. This one's a good color. So the dark forest is a dark place, if you couldn't tell by the name. The dark forest is a very dark place. I know that in this forest some trauma holders are stuck. I don't know what trauma they're holding. I don't have access to the forest. I think I could go in there if I would feel ready for it. I know that our gatekeeper, Akuma, trusts me a lot, knows I can handle a lot, but I know that it's okay that I'm not there and that I don't actively there. So there's a lot of purple in here. I think someone put purple on here. Okay, so what else can I say? I was in the dark forest, like in front of it, like near where you can exit it. I can peek in there. It's just very dark, like the name. It's a dark forest. It's pretty dark. There is no light from the suns. The trees are very very thick. The leaves are very thick. There is no sunlight getting in. It's quite scary. It's actually a quite scary place. And I'm not sure if I will ever want to go there. So I'm trying to now make trees because it's a forest. But I'm not sure if you can make trees with makeup. I'm sure you can, but probably not with the skills I have, which are not really a lot. So the dotting I'm doing right now is to resemble like leaves, like so it has a different texture to the other blank stuff. The forest has a huge role as well, and I'm not sure if other alters will ever include it, but in my part of the inner world it has a big role since it's just outside my own home. It's outside of my head. My head is in front of the forest. It's a part of where I live. That's why I want to include it. I'm not even sure if this even looks like a scenery anymore. It's more like a huge blob of color. Okay, what I'm now going to do is I'm going to blend in this dark stuff with the light scenery. Trauma happened to us. Trauma happened to some system members, but it did happen to our body and to our mind. We shouldn't just ignore it. It is a part of our life, but it's not defining our life. It shouldn't define our life. Your trauma doesn't define you. All of you are so much more than trauma. All of us are more than our trauma. Some of us don't even know that we have trauma. Or, of course, they know that something has happened because otherwise we wouldn't have this disorder. But they don't know what exactly happened. But there are other alters that think that all they are is the pain they hold. But that's not true. You are more than that. And I think it's important to say that. So now we have the dark forest part, the sky, we have the grass and the lavender. I wanted to make the eyeshadow in the colors my hut is made out of. And the hut I live in is pretty brown. It's a very warm and quite contrasting against the like cold or colder nature. That's why I'm going to put it in this color. So much on the internet these days, like useful stuff. I'm very, very thankful to have this platform to share our story, to voice ourselves, and we can definitely do something with that. I'm pretty sure we can make a little difference. So this is my hat. So that doesn't look like a hat, but that's alright. It's just the colors. Now I'm going to do my usual makeup on the other side with it, which is just pastelly pink or pastelly green or pastelly teal or pastelly blue eyeshadow. I'm not used to doing eyebrows. Isa usually does that. Also, again, do you think these videos or these kind of videos are interesting? Are you interested in watching them? It really is something I'm wondering. I will do some blue eyeliner. I really kind of like it. Also, I'm not very good at blue eyeliner or eyeliner in general, so I hope you can bear with that. It looks horrible. So now I'm gonna put on my lipstick, just broke. So that is my lipstick done. I now just have to put on mascara and highlighter, but I start with the mascara. This look really kind of captures, I hope hope this look really kind of captures my personality as well. I'm usually not wearing blue eyeliner like that. It's like on special days when I feel really good and a bit brighter than usual. So just for you, it's a special day. That's why I'm going to do that. Lastly, I will put on my wig. Okay. So this is me with my wig. This is me in the makeup look. I think it's the best I could do. It really captures my soul. The pastelly things I really love. It captures the place I live with this cold, more springy aura, with my warm, safe space, comfy home I live in. Forest that even though it's dark, I don't see in this bad perception others might think it is. I know it's not a good place, but it is there for a reason, and that's why I don't see it as dark as it is, or as dark as others think it is. That's why it's blended in. It's still a part of us. It shouldn't be cut out. It's still there, and it's important. I will take some pictures. I will put them in right now. And lastly, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's quite long. I apologize for that. Leave a like, comment down below if you would like to see us continue, if there's any alter you would like to see this do, then write it down below. Subscribe to our channel if you're new. Have a look over to our Patreon. The link is in the description. If you have any story or message you want to share with us and our community in a video, then DM us on Instagram or send a mail to pizzasharinglove@gmail.com. It's also written below, so we will see you in the next video. Goodbye.